ladies and gentlemen, the long-awaited day has finally arrived. After 2 years of prolonged construction works in the campus, we have finally come together for the annual day celebrations. On this eventful day, I am glad to present before you a brief history and the report of the school. Holy Trinity Convent School was established 8 years ago at Dansal in the district of Jammu. Travelling from Jammu along the National Highway 1A, one needs to divert from Domel towards Jindra, just about 3 kilometers to locate the campus. The school is just 18 kilometers away from the famous Sri Vaishnamata temple at Katra. The school is situated in a stunning location surrounded by gorgeous hills. It is a Christian minority education institution owned and administrated by the Jammu Srinagar Diocesan Education Society, whose parent organization is the Diocese of Jammu Srinagar. Most Reverend Dr. Peter Celestine, the Bishop of the Diocese, is the sponsor of this institution. We are glad that he is right in our midst today. Jammu Srinagar Diocesan Education Society owns schools in Leh Ladakh, Baramulla, Srinagar, Jammu, Udhampur, and Kathua districts. Most of these schools are in the rural backward area, as its motto is to reach out to the unreached. We, the Trinitarian family, is proud to be part of such a committed and development-oriented society. Under the auspicious guidance and administration of Reverend Father Jay Kumar, the far-sighted chairman, Reverend Father Sebastian Nagatungal, the able treasurer, and other members of the Diocesan Education Board, we are all grateful to each and every one of them. Holy Trinity Convent School was begun in the year 1999. With lower kindergarten, adding up a class every year, as per the directives from the esteemed director, School Education, Jammu Kashmir, the school has now reached up to 6th standard. Our sincere thanks to the ever appreciative officials of the government of Jammu Kashmir. We would like to impart the values of learning, loving, and living. It is through learning one recognizes the truth, which is nothing but love. And these two values together build up a happy and successful life. Thus, the school prepares the younger generation and through them, the older generation, for a worthy human life with full dignity. Hence, the motto of the school is learn, love, and live. Our patron is the Holy Trinity, and our task is to achieve the harmonious communion that exists among the sacred three of the Trinity. We do experience every moment the providential and protecting hands of the Trinity in the life course of our institution. Reverend Sister Lena was the first principal, followed by Reverend Father Francis V. Under their able administration, the management turned the hostile environment into a cordial one. Our school has a well-qualified and a hard-working team of teaching and non-teaching staff members. They impart education and perform other responsibilities with love and firmness. Students do not find any difficulties in relating to their teachers. The hard work of the teachers is well reflected in the attitudes, behavior, and output of the students. I unreservedly appreciate the staff members. I do firmly believe that whatever stature the school has achieved today is because of their sense of accountability and commitment. Sisters of Nazareth from Kerala assist the principal in day-to-day administration. I am proud to state that these religious sisters are my able collaborators, thanks to their dedicated personalities. Let us now glance through some of our activities. We begin our day with assembly in the morning, the most sacred hour of the day. All of us together seek God's blessings for the effective fulfilling of responsibilities and learning experiences. Readings from the sacred scripture of different religions are read out and enlightened by the teachers. Our students conduct assembly class-wise and house-wise. Within limited period, students get abundant opportunities to exhibit their talents in front of their companions and the staff members. We celebrate the birthdays of our students during the morning assembly. Bruce Barton says, "Sometimes when I consider what tremendous consequences come from little things, I am tempted to think that there are no little things. Hence, we seek accountability in so-called little things. To promote such an opportunity of accountability, leadership, and efficiency, students are assigned to be head boy and head girl, school leaders, house captains, and class monitors. Moreover, to create performance opportunities and to promote creativity and excellence through positive competition, the students are grouped in four different houses: success, victory, triumph, and conquest are the names of these houses, which indicate the seriousness of the school management to infuse the concept of success within the students at this very early stage of their formation. Competitions in cultural, academic, and sports and games are conducted every year, and the winners are recognized with awards and certificates. We couldn't organize any competitions in sports and games field this year, as the playground was occupied with materials of construction. Our students participate in programs organized by government and non-government agencies for the welfare of children and society. A team of students were trained and animated by Sister Jyotis, the local coordinator of Catholic Social Service Society of Jammu and Kashmir. These students went around 15 villages where they performed Nukat Natak on the social, religious, and health issues such as dowry, superstitions, caste, girl-child education, AIDS, etc. They also participated in a poster-making competition conducted by the same NGO. We in our school celebrate all major religious festivals such as Deepavali, Eid, and Christmas. National days such as Independence Day and Republic Day. And social events such as AIDS Day, Women's Day, Teachers Day, and Children's Day. Stephen R. Covey asks in the best-selling book, The 7 Habits of Highly Effective People, why don't you take a break for a few minutes and sharpen that saw? We do feel the necessity of taking a break to refresh and re-energize. Hence, we take our children for picnicking and trekking. Moreover, students receive training in and play games like kabaddi, kho-kho, football, volleyball, hockey, and cricket. Jackalay Unit Center, Dansal, organized at our behest a Know Your Jawan program. It was indeed an information-packed session. The officers had taken enormous efforts to make it a successful venture, thanks to Major Rathore and his co-workers. Students are asked to give priority to health. We initiate discussion with the parents of the physically infirm students. We organize medical checkups in the school. Dental specialists from Public Health Center Dansal, on our request, organized a dental checkup of the students and teachers. Thanks to Dr. Basant Kumar Sharma, the block medical officer Dansal, and his associates. As part of our inter-school interaction, our students had the privilege of receiving the computer club students of St. Francis High Secondary School, Akanur. It was indeed an enriching experience for our little kids. They learned a lot from their visiting seniors. Thanks to Reverend Father Jay Kumar, the principal, and his computer staff members who made this a possibility. Now it's time to glimpse through some of the facilities provided in the school for our children. We have a building with an imposing look, well-furnished, brighter classrooms with cross ventilation. We have sufficient playground, and our students get needed exposure to learn and play different games. Our school has a library, which the children regularly make use for reading and for acquiring knowledge. Though smaller, the library is a functioning one. We have incoming magazines and periodicals for the help of the teachers and students to inquire into the recent happenings. The students are motivated to cultivate reading into a habit. We have bought a new school bus for the comfortable transportation of children from Katra, Sukhetar, and Jajarkotli areas. We have a well-furnished, modernized computer lab. It has 14 computers with color monitors, all with window-based programs. A 15 kV generator is installed for the undisrupted functioning of the computers. The school imparts self-defense education to our students. In collaboration with Kamat India, patronized by Kamat International. Recently, 7 of our students have been awarded first degree black belt by Grandmaster Hugh Gardiner from Australia. Previously, 9 more students had been awarded the same degree last year. The school is gifted with an administrative block. We have a new waiting room for the visitors. A new stage for the school is built. It is named Trinity Rang Mandir, in front of which you have all gathered. A lot of renovation and beautification works have been on for the past 7 months. Road to the school building is widened. A new entrance to the school is built. Compound walls have been restructured. With the blessings of the sponsor and collaboration of the parents, we have a few future plans for the welfare of the students. Upgrading the school to high school level, a well-furnished science lab, inserting annual year planner in the school diary, publication of a school magazine named Stand Up, a standard basketball playground, water cooling points for drinking water, and tarring of the road to the school building. On this occasion, I sincerely express my heartfelt thanks to everyone who has been providing us with support. To parents and guardians, a special word of thanks, for without your collaboration, we can do nothing. For you are a great source of support and strength to our students and our institution. With these expressions of gratitude, I conclude this annual report. Thank you. May God bless you.